Hey, welcome to Robinson Foundry. In this video, I'm going to show you how I made a set of solid copper mugs. But first, why would anybody want a copper mug? Well, copper is an extremely good thermal conductor, so when you pour in a cold drink, the cup instantly changes to the same temperature. Now that's great for cold drinks, but not so much for hot ones, as I learned the hard way. I really wanted to make these mugs as interesting looking as possible, so I looked around online for some inspiration and eventually came up with this. When I was finished with my design, I 3D printed them using a plastic called PLA. Once the 3D prints were finished, I assembled the cups using superglue, and I also used a small amount of wax to fill in and smooth out the joint. This stuff is called Suspendaslurry. It's a liquid ceramic that's used to make ceramic shell molds for metal casting. Over the course of a week, I dipped the models into the slurry 9 times. After each coat, I sprinkled on some silica sand, which helped build up a thick shell. Once I was finished coating the models, I let the shells dry out for over a week to make sure that they were completely dry, and then I placed them inside my kiln to burn away the plastic and turn the shells into ceramic. The models were printed using a plastic called PLA. PLA works great for this process because of its relatively low melting point and its ability to be burned away without leaving any ash behind. I slowly brought up the temperature in the kiln to the melting point of the PLA. Once the majority of the plastic had melted out of the shells, I opened up the kiln and removed it. Then I cranked up the temperature to around 1500 degrees Fahrenheit. This vitrifies the shells, turning them into ceramic that can withstand the temperature of molten copper. While the shells were heating up, I loaded my crucible with some copper scrap and then fired up my furnace. I figured that 6 pounds of copper should be enough to fill both the molds. Once the copper was melted, I removed the shells from the kiln and poured in the metal as quickly as possible. The next day, I broke open the molds to reveal the castings. Soaking the shells in water first helped keep the dust from floating around as I broke them apart. Well, despite some problems with surface finish, they actually look really good. I'm not really sure what caused the defects, but it's possible it was from ash left inside the mold. Honestly, I kind of like how these little cracks look, so I didn't try to fix it. To remove the shell from the inside of the mugs, I used my sandblaster to cut it in half. This helped release the grip the shell had on the casting and made it possible to just knock the shell out. After cleaning them up with a sandblaster, I remove part of the sprues. There were a couple holes caused by shrinkage. This happens because as the metal cools, it shrinks and pulls metal in towards the last part to solidify. Fortunately, I was able to use a TIG welder to fill in the holes. Before cutting off the entire sprue, I realized I could grab hold of the sprue with my lathe, and that really helped with polishing the inside of the mugs. Next, I drilled and tapped the mugs to make it possible to attach some wooden handles. My goal was to create an interesting look that would enhance the overall design of the mugs. I decided to use walnut wood for the handles. After drilling in the necessary holes, I carved the shapes out with a knife until I was happy with how they looked. Once I was finished carving the handles, I used some oil to seal them. As a finishing touch, I stamped my channel's initials and the year on the bottom of each mug. Once that was done, I used a die grinder to polish the mugs to a smooth and shiny finish. Well, they're done. I think these things turned out really cool looking, and it's nice to make something that I can actually use. Like I said in the beginning, copper cups are interesting because, with copper being so conductive, it takes on the temperature of the liquid almost instantly. Copper cups can be used for all sorts of drinks, but the Moscow Mule is by far the most popular, so I had to make one. This was my first time trying this, and I have to say it wasn't bad. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed watching me make these, and if you did, please let me know what you think in the comments, give the video a thumbs up, and subscribe for future videos. As usual, I'll have affiliate links in the description for products I've used in this video, as well as things I would recommend. Well, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.